I just can't believe how exhausting these past 48 hours have been. I haven't slept.
Do you think we've slept?
Oh.
Do you think we've properly slept?
I'm just processing.
We have been on a roller coaster of emotions unfolding this album, getting to know these songs, a whole new meaning from when we first recorded them.
Oh, there's just so much to say. There's so much to say.
And I want to say thank you guys so freaking much, because your comments led us on
the right paths.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. And we just love your enthusiasm and how you're feeling, and love that we can connect with you guys over this. It's just such a special time having this album.
Oh, it is. And just knowing that there are people out there who get it, like, who understand how you can love one person so much because of everything she's done for us.
Everything she's done for us.
I can't put into words what Taylor Swift has done for me over the course of my life, but just the past two days
has absorbed our entire weekend. We haven't been able to do anything else but listen to these songs. And like, even just yesterday we listened to like the whole album, but particularly 5 or 6 songs on repeat, so that we could let them absorb and let them understand them, because there's so much to unpack, so much detail, more than ever before.
So really, why we're filming this video is because we have not yet watched the Cardigan music video.
Yeah.
We just needed 24 hours to process the album.
Yeah. Before we could react.
Yeah.
We want to give a brief overview of like how the album's changed for us, because we've realized, if you've watched our last video, I pinned the comment, but we've realized a lot of these songs on the album are about her losing her albums, about Scott selling her past albums because she never owned them, even though she wrote them, and just that painful process that she's gone through. And she's also intertwined it with a love story, a love affair, and that's why it's called Folklore, because it's stories that everyone can connect to, but has this underlying message of this process. And I am so relieved, because now we understand Hoax. It's not about Joe. It's about that, the faithless love that she thought she had, and he, you know, because she had such a personal relationship with her record label, because she's been with them since she was 15. So it's heartbreaking.
Yeah.
What he did to
her. It just makes perfect sense in the context of her life to be drawing so much inspiration from this pain that she feels over her relationship with Scott ending, with her record label, for losing her diaries, her work, her life's work. And to draw from that inspiration and write about it like it's a relationship, like it's a love affair.
Genius.
Perfect.
So genius.
Perfect.
And it's also perfectly helping people understand the pain that she went through, because not everyone's going to be able to understand what that's like to lose a family, because essentially that's what that record label would have been for her. Her family, they would have had such a close family relationship, and also her work and how much that means to her to not be able to own it. And
absolutely.
Go into the arms of Scooter?
Oh.
Disgusting. Ugh. No. This is so wrong. This is so wrong. In particular, songs like My Tears Ricochet, definitely about Scott.
We're thinking that Hoax. The One is about Scott. Yep. We're thinking that Hoax is about Scott.
Maybe even illicit affairs. Yeah.
We think that...
She says, don't call me kid, don't call me baby. Look at this godforsaken mess that you've made me.
Oh, yeah.
Mess.
Oh, yeah. Just a mess.
It's just an absolute mess.
We think that even though we know now that Cardigan, August, and Betty are this story of this love triangle, we think that Betty is written from the perspective of what she would want Scott to say to her, to make it up to her.
And Cardigan is obviously a love song to the fans. Put Me On and said you were my favorite. Yes, because that's what they did for her. And that's what she did for us.
Oh, my God. This album is really... It's the best thing she's ever done. I can say that with so much certainty, because how could the best thing that she's ever done not be what she has now written for us?
Yes.
She's written this for us.
And about the music.
Oh my God. And just to know that she feels about us, the fans, the ones who have stuck by her for so many years through all of the shit that she's gone through, she appreciates that as much as we appreciate what she has done for us through her music. It's and just simply overwhelming.
It's overwhelming. And can I say, so many people have messaged me saying, oh my God, you guys have brought me back to Taylor after, you know, not listening to her since Red or 1989 or something. And she's even acknowledging those fans in that song by being like, I knew you'd come back to me.
Oh,
because I am your favorite. And you are my favorite.
And she is a mirror ball for us.
Oh, the mirror ball, Yes, mirror ball.
She tells us who we are through her writing about her life and us relating. We find parts of ourselves through her music.
In the songs.
She knows that about us.
Just that lyric, I will show you every version of yourself tonight. Tonight, and the album was released at midnight.
Oh my god!
Yeah, but I mean, that could obviously be about Joe as well. But I think taking that as a song to the fans is so beautiful.
Oh, it is. Anyways, we're just so excited now to react to the Cardigan music video.
Yeah.
I think that this reaction has come in a perfect time now that we've realized how heavily it's possible that this song was written for the fans, mm-hmm. because it just adds this new spin, this new meaning, this new depth to the song. And I think that we're going to get more out of the music video today than what we would have if we had watched it
on
the day that it was released.
I'm so glad we know this.
I'm so excited.
Okay,
I'm so excited to watch
it.
Yeah, we need to watch it.
Okay. Let's watch this video.
Oh my god.
That piano.
Oh my god. I just want to know where she filmed this already. I already want to know. Vintage tea, brand new phone, high heels on, cobblestones. When you are young, they assume you know nothing. Is she kidding me? She's perfection.
She's
already perfection.
She's already perfection. And we just want to talk about those lyrics quickly. She's going through her phases. Like,
she's going through her areas.
Yeah, she says high heels on cobblestones. So that's like the red era.
Oh,
and then she's like black lipstick and a sequin smile. That's like the red, the rep era. And she's like, when you are young, they assume you know nothing. But
wait, let's actually have a look at this. Vintage tea, brand new phone.
Vintage tea?
High heels on cobblestones. When you are young, they assume you know nothing. Sequin smile, black lipstick,
sensual politics.
Slobber. Oh my god. I don't even know like how you, as a human, write about your own past errors so poetically. How does she do that?
And
like, it's not even obvious that she's singing about her past errors.
No, it's not. But when you know, you know. When even just her saying, they assume you know nothing when you're younger, but I knew you. I knew the fans. I always knew that.
Oh my god, we haven't even gotten there either.
I know.
I just want to say about what I'm actually looking at here. I have a prediction. That painting she painted, and that is a picture of her grandfather.
Yes.
Who Epiphany's about.
Beautiful. And there's a clock as well.
Oh my god. Oh, wait, what is that?
Oh my god, what time is it?
It is
quarter past one. You know that fucking has a meaning.
Oh, you know that has a meaning, of course.
Look at her. Black lipstick,
sensual politics. Oh, she fucking knows what she did then.
Did she stop singing? Oh, that's so beautiful.
Oh my god, what's happening? Oh my god, I need to keep playing.
Oh shit! Oh my god! Oh my god, it transformed her to this beautiful place. That's where the piano takes her.
I need to own this dress. I need to own this dress.
Look at her hair!
I'm buying that dress.
How that piano took her from that dark room into this heavenly paradise.
Music is everywhere.
Oh my god, lifting up the piano and getting in, that's just such a good idea, and it was all gold and beautiful and magical, just like the fans.
Oh my god, but I'm sorry, gold is also Joe.
Gold is also Joe, I know.
Oh my god, I need to keep playing.
Look at that visual!
That's not a superior thing I've ever seen.
I know you. You copied on the highline.
say, she said that she dressed and did her makeup and hair and everything by herself for this music video. Superior.
And you can totally tell that it's just her being herself.
Oh, she's so herself.
And it's stunning. It's actually stunning how little fucks she gives.
Oh, she doesn't need to do anything.
She's so comfortable in herself.
Yeah, she
just oozes.
She doesn't need to try anymore. I mean, she never had to try, but she was trying. She doesn't need to try anymore. She just is.
She is. This album is a flow of her consciousness.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, my God.
I can't get over the visuals. I can't get over the visuals.
Sorry, I thought I heard. Oh, my God, the water in the piano. Always, you're always my favorite.
Absolutely overwhelmed by this visual that I'm seeing.
Oh my God, I know, it's beautiful.
With the moss on the piano and the water pouring out.
I love, do you know how they filmed this? Like, obviously, a lot of it would be like CGI, but like, I still want to know.
The visuals and the effects are just perfect. So perfect. She's
saved her. The piano.
Always. She goes back to it. It's her only saving grace. When she's drowning, she turns to the music, she turns to the fans. Oh my God, I can't believe how good this symbolism is. It's actually overwhelming.
Oh my God. When you are young, they assume you know nothing.
I think we just need to talk about those lyrics there, because remember when we were talking about before how that is a real honest raw lyric saying like, I knew you'd haunt all of my what ifs, like I'm giving you.
Oh, actually we need to talk about this. Yeah. Yes, because we realized that Cardigan could very likely be about the fans. Actually, someone commented that on our video.
Yeah.
And it just led us on this path of discovering what this song really means.
Yeah.
And it's amazing because she's explaining how much she loves us and appreciates us. She, when she felt like she was an old cardigan under someone's bed, we put her on and said that she was our favorite, but she's also being so real. So like real. You said, like she knew in putting herself into her music and her past songs and her, they're like her diaries. Like,
and
she knew,
them up for her.
She knew we'd bring them back up. She knew going into this relationship with her fans,
we would haunt all of her what ifs. That is such a perfect way of putting it, because fans bring up past relationships, past things that she's done. What if I did it like this? What if I did it like that? Haunt all of, even just like how, like songs that she's put on the albums, and we're like, why? Like, what if you gave us this instead? And she's like, what if?
And even the next lyric, I knew I'd curse you for the longest time. Of course, it's a complex relationship with her fans. Of course she has to curse us sometimes, because we bring up painful things for her, because we're constantly revisiting old songs. Like the fact that she's rediscovered and started playing All Too Well during the Love era, and how much hurt was held in that song for her, and now we've completely... But of course she would go through a phase where she would curse us for loving that song so much, because she doesn't want to revisit that emotion, but we've changed it for her.
And she's cursing us as well, because we've had memories and feelings attached to songs that are constantly re-brought up because of how we feel when we listen to that song.
Oh, some of her songs I cannot even listen to
because
of the pain that it brings from my own life.
Yeah.
And I know that a lot of, every one of her big fans feels that way about some of her songs.
Yeah.
And it's still a perfect song, but it's just so hard to listen sometimes because of the meaning it holds for you and for her. So I totally get why she curses us.
And it's such a poetic way of wording it.
Oh,
it's so beautiful.
It's so perfect. It's so perfect.
It's so perfect. Chasing shadows in the grocery line.
I feel like chasing shadows in the grocery line just really could be symbolism for just her fame in general. Just like, I'm cursing you because I didn't necessarily want this life, want this fame, but I also love you all so much.
Yes.
For the love and the support that you give to me.
Yeah, she's noticing and acknowledging the complicated life that it is to be
famous. But she's
famous
explaining to us, she's like, it's not, it can't always all be love.
No.
Like, we have an imperfect relationship with each other.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean that, like, we are the
it's
most important
so
thing
honest.
To her.
It's just like the most honest and real song.
And just the poetic way that she's written about it, like it's a love story, like how we've all discovered that those three songs together are just this complex triangle, this three-way love, you know?
Yes.
The way that she's framed it like that, but it's actually a love song to her fans.
Yeah.
Oh, I can't. I need to keep watching.
I need to keep watching too. So good. I just quickly say the metaphor for the cardigan is so incredibly perfect because it's warming, it's comforting,
it's cozy. Your favorite
cardigan.
Oh, it means so much.
It's like being held. Held, and she holds us and we hold her. Perfect metaphor. And yes, we have bought this cardigan. We're so excited for it to arrive.
What's gonna happen for the last 30 seconds?
Yeah, what else is happening?
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god.
I love that she directed that. Of course. She came up with that brilliance.
It's her.
It's completely her. No one else could have thought of that.
A special thank you to our on-set medics, COVID-19 compliance personnel, and the crew for operating under the strictest guidelines, including wearing PPE, practicing through sanitization, and respecting social distancing during the video shoot. Oh,
of course she did.
She is a superior human.
Oh, absolutely. Do you think she would be inconsiderate in any way, shape, or form when it comes to this? God.
It's like, I think she knows what this means to fans, but I actually don't think she knows. She cannot conceptualize what it is to be a fan of her.
No, because she is her, and she doesn't get to witness the greatness that is her. It's fucking actually too overwhelming.
Being her.
I'm sorry, that's her best music video ever.
Because it's so personal.
It's so personal, it's all from her.
Oh my god.
And it's such a superior metaphor. I just can't believe she did that.
That amazing music video, amazing album, amazing person. I simply cannot say
enough things about
I cannot what this sing means. Higher praises of her.
No. This has topped it. I honestly thought no album would top Reputation.
And I didn't think that any album would top 1989.
But this is there. This is absolutely there. And because it's so personal and because it's about this,
it's number one.
It is. It has to be. It's to us. It's to the music. It's to everything that she's been through with the music. And it makes so much sense because, of course, this is what she's been going through over the last 6 months is thinking about this album. Like, how dare we think that anything is about anything other than that? And, of course, I still think there are elements that are odes to Joe, and maybe still Exile has odes to Calvin in there somewhere. But I think that there is a lot of inspiration drawn mainly from the fans, her relationship with Scott, and her relationship with the
albums. And just the pain of losing her albums. Like, I can't imagine how deeply painful that would be for her. Of course, it's like her most depressing breakup. That's why this album is so melancholy.
Yeah.
Like, she's so sad.
Because we felt that in the hoax as well. Like, we can't believe, like, this can't be about Joe, and it's so sad, and I don't understand. But of course it's about this. Of course it's about this. The only thing I sort of understand in the hoax is when she says, my favorite shade of blue. Like, I still feel like that is very connected to Joe, but maybe that will... maybe listening to that again a few more times will make a little bit more sense.
Yeah. I think that there's a lot to discover about this album in the coming weeks.
There is.
The whole realization of what this album could potentially mean and where the inspiration for it has been drawn from and coming to that in a day.
No, it's too much.
Think of where we will all be.
I know, that's
in a month.
That's what we're saying. In a month, we're thinking of maybe going back through the album in detail. If you guys would like to see that, please let us know. And obviously, we're going to keep talking to you guys in the comments down below. I love discovering this with you and hearing your insights.
It means so much to just know that there are people out there who get this. I know I've said that.
It really does. We've been overwhelmed with emotion the last 2 days just because it's like, it just feels
only
so good.
Only we get what this means. Yeah. We're doing this.
Yeah. Oh. And I just like, at the same time, I feel like so bad that for anyone that's not experiencing this.
Oh, I feel so sad for people who aren't utterly in love with Taylor Swift.
Yeah.
Like, it's just it's a deep love. I don't think anything can match what Taylor Swift gives to her fans. Like, there's not a love out there that exists that is more important than Taylor Swift. And how she can explain in perfected words everything that we feel when we move through life with all of her songs.
And this album in particular, but all of her albums, every lyric means something. The words hold so much value and so much detail, and the way she manages to wrap it up in one sentence, like even just saying, you put me on and said I was your favorite. Sorry, that is just so much detail.
It's a perfect symbolism. It's a perfect symbolism. Oh, so am I. Anyways, that was a superior music video. I don't think there's anything else to say. Amazing album.
We're not alive right now. We've just been
so exhausted.
We've just been in this music, and I can't do anything else.
Oh, speaking of, literally a lyric in this song is giving me your weekend. I have just given her. This whole weekend, my life revolves around her this weekend.
Give me your weekends. Oh, yes. And she knew what she was doing.
Oh, she knew when she released this song that we would be giving her our weekend.
Absolutely.
With this song being released.
And it's honestly
with this album being released.
One of the best weekends of my entire life.
Oh my God, absolutely. Nothing can top it. Anyways, thank you so much for watching.
Yeah,
so glad you guys
so
are loving everything that we've done so far. Yeah. And I hope that you love this video just as much.
Wow, we have weeks ahead to uncover this album fully, and it's so exciting.
This is so exciting. Oh my God.
Okay, we'll see.